the kind of content that you're getting to see on web these days, whether it be through short films or videos or series, I mean, it's way more experimental. It's way more today. Like, you know, there are a lot of great concepts which you never think of making movies about, because there goes a lot behind making a film and releasing it. So this is a great platform, not just for filmmakers, but also for actors like us who want to experiment and do different kind of things. It was a lot of fun. I mean, I was playing a married woman, which was very alien to me, because I've never, even for a second in my life, felt married or attached to that extent. But it was really, it was a lot of fun. It was a fun character. She was a stand-up comedian. She had a crazy husband who loves her, like, who loves her so much. And I think the chemistry between the two was what appealed to me. And it was really funny on paper. And when I read it the first time, I knew I wanted to do something like this, because after the range of thrillers and horrors that I'd done, it was quite a breath of fresh air for me. I would love to do stand-up comedy. I think that's one of the most one of those things that really terrify me, but at the same time really excite me. But I think I'm funny, but other people don't think so. So I think if I get a great writer to kind of back up my thoughts and write them well, I would love to give it a hand. Yeah, they're very different. I think Shweta is very mature as a character, and she really understands and handles things in, you know, having the kind of crazy husband that she has and the kind of mother-in-law she has, the kind of mother she has in the show. So I think I would have probably murdered them all by now. I really like the series that I watched. I think I finished it a week ago. It was called The Handmaid's Tale, and it's a futuristic series which is based on an era like probably 100, 200 years from now, where the environment is in a very bad shape and it has caused people to go back to the normal way of living. And the fertility in women is gone down, so the government has taken over and basically kidnapped, you can say, all the few fertile women that are left in the country, and basically subjected them to slavery in a way. They trained them and they send them as handmaids to these powerful, wealthy homes to breed children for them. It is so easy to access, it is everywhere, and most of it is free, so it's become a very interesting medium for people, not just work wise but even as a viewer. The freedom of content and the freedom of doing what you want to do is a major factor. I have no clue. That is one thing even I am tempted to No, and that will only come, I think, with time, once I have done everything that I wanted, or at least experimented as much as I want to. So that is something I don't know. I hope it's good though. It takes a lot from you to do a horror film. I mean, aisa lagta hai ki bahut aasan hai, cheekna chillana, there's all the same thing, you know, every time you watch a film, it's just for the thrill of it. But I think I want to, you know, distance myself from that zone for a while. So unless and until it's some kick-ass script, I think I wouldn't go for a horror as of now. My goal is to be a filmmaker very soon, do my own shit as well, not just follow others. So I think I would want to be a director, a stylist, a writer, and try my hand at making things happen rather than just going with the flow.
For all the latest updates on web entertainment, log on to thedigitalhash.com.